Hey everyone, Eric here. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to use sensitivity analysis in Microsoft Excel to help calculate the break-even point of a business. So first off, what is sensitivity analysis? It's here in the Data tab, and it's under What If Analysis. What If Analysis functions help us to analyze situations where we change variables, inputs, so in our case, those would be the assumptions of the underlying business, like the price, like the customer return rate, things like this, to try to look at how those inputs affect outputs. So in a financial model, the outputs are any of the metrics in the model, the revenue. And the output that we're analyzing in terms of break-even is the operating profit. So with sensitivity analysis, you look at different combinations of inputs and how those combinations create different outputs. So first off, let's take a look at the model and then I'll dive in to show you exactly how to perform this type of analysis. It's a very, very powerful type of analysis that I use all the time. Okay, first off, so we have a basic income statement. We have revenue, you know, cost of goods sold, gross profit, then typical operating expenses, personnel, advertising, you know, other OPEX, which is like fixed expenses, and then your profit. So what are the inputs going into this model? So first off, in terms of the revenue, we need to figure out how many new customers we have coming in the business. So this is very simplified, but the structure of this is actually how you build a much more complicated model, so you can learn something from this. So we have the advertising budget. Then we have something called the customer acquisition cost. The customer acquisition cost, if you don't know what it is, and I'll include a link to another video where I explain it in depth below, but is the total marketing dollars you spend to get one new customer to buy at your company. So for instance, let's say that you spent $100 on Facebook advertising, and through those ads, two new customers purchased your product. The customer acquisition cost would be the 100 divided by two, so it would be $50 in marketing for each new customer who comes to the business. So in our case, we're saying that the customer acquisition cost is $75. So to calculate the total new customers, all you do is you divide the advertising budget by the customer acquisition cost. And that gets you the total new customers. In addition, let's say year one is like our launch year, but in year two, we have a lot of customers from year one who come back and they return and they buy again in year two. So we have an annual return rate of 50%, and we calculate returning customers as the total customers from year one, and 50% of them come back and they buy again in year two. And then again, in year three, we have the total customers from year two, 50% of them come back and buy in year three, and then we have our total customers. So all we need to do is take this and multiply it by the average order value, so that's the average revenue for one order, and we get the revenue. So we just multiply those two things together, customers times average order value, we get the revenue. Similarly, the cost of goods sold is just the total customers times the average cost of goods sold per order. Finally, and this is the easy part, personnel is just a number that we got basically straight from our assumptions. Let's assume, you know, the team is a couple people and it's not going to be growing. The advertising spend we just pulled straight from here. And finally, other OPEX we pulled straight from here. And then we have our operating profit. So our company has investors. They want us to try to break even in year two or three. So first they want to know, hey, can you break even in year two? And so there's so many combinations of variables that could create a break-even situation, but how powerful are these different combinations of each variable? So question one, they say, okay, what return rate and advertising spend could get you profitable in year two? So we're gonna look at that. So let's set up a sensitivity table. So sensitivity table, rule number one, the rows and columns, these two sections right here, must be hard-coded. No linking, no formulas, you gotta just type the information in. So let's start. So we know that on one hand, we're gonna look at the return rate, right? And on the other hand, they want us to look at advertising spend. So let's just say ad spend. And again, this is all in year two. Let's make it a little shorter, year two. Okay, so the second rule, and if you break these rules, you're gonna be leaving me tons and tons of comments and saying that my video was wrong, blah, blah, blah. If you follow these rules, everything's gonna go great. So rule number two, you must link in the metric that you are analyzing in the top left-hand corner. So that is operating profit in year two. This is what we want to understand. So return rate. So our base return rate in the model here is 50%. Okay, so let's put in some other return rates. So 30%, 40%, 50%, 60%, 70%, 80%, and let's say 90%. Probably anything higher than that is ridiculous. And then second, we have advertising. So our base advertising in year two is 400,000. And now let's basically show like a range of situations, because they say at what return rate and advertising spend could you become profitable in year two? So we don't know if that means, hey, what if we spent less? Could we be profitable? What if we spent more? Could we be profitable? So here you can see that I'm just showing sort of a range from 100,000 all the way to 700,000. Okay, now highlight the entire table, including the rows, the columns, and your linked cell. Go to the data tab, click what if analysis, and then click data table. Now it says row input cell. This is the assumption that we are modeling in the row. So that's the return rate in year two. Column input cell. This is the advertising spend in year two. So now click OK. Okay, so what exactly are we seeing here? So these are all of the different operating profits that we would have at these different combinations of variables. So here at an 80% return rate and 500,000 in advertising spend, we would have 159,000 in operating profit. And at a 40% return rate and 200,000 in advertising spend, we would have negative 213,000 in operating profit. So what is this basically telling us? Well, I think the main thing it's telling us is that we're not going to be breaking even in year two. So we would have to go back to our investors and say, look, we've done the analysis, but I don't think this business can break even in year two. Maybe it can break even in year three. We should look at that. So that leads to the next question. Question two. So they say, okay, fine. Year three. Okay, what if you lowered your cost of goods sold and you also did a lot more advertising in year two? Do you think by year three you could get profitable if you spent a lot more in ads in year two and you got a lot of new customers into the business in the second year, which then became returning customers in the third year? Okay, so this is a little complicated, but it's a perfect situation for a sensitivity table. So I'm just going to copy down my format because I can reuse some of this. I'm going to delete the inside of the table. And okay, so they said how much, you know, what if we really bumped up our advertising spend in year two? Would that make us profitable in year three? And the other thing they wanted us to look at is not return rate, but it's cost of goods sold. And so assuming our cost of goods sold is the same every year, we'll be modeling this in year three. Okay, so cost of goods sold. So our cost of goods sold, we're saying it's $37, but let's put $37 as the highest because they say, hey, you know, what can you do to lower this number? So let's say, you know, we can negotiate with some vendors, we can change, you know, the way we're doing something, and we think we can get that number a little lower. So finally, our output, in this case, this was the EBIT in year two, but now we're looking at EBIT in year three. Okay, so here we link in our operating profit. And again, just remember, year three operating profit, link it in. Okay, table is set up. Will this thing break even in year three? Click what if analysis, data table. Whoops, sorry, I highlighted too much. So highlight the table, click what if analysis, data table. So the row is your cost of goods sold in year three, and you can see that here. And your column is your advertising in year two. So can you acquire so many customers in year two that you break that you break even in year three. So click OK. And the answer to this question is actually yes. So you see, these are all the situations where we spend $700,000 in advertising in year two. And in the model, we had $400,000. So you can see that actually in any of these scenarios, even if our cost of goods sold is still at $37, we'll actually break even in year three. So this is where you would go to, you know, the board of directors and say, look, we need to invest a lot more money in year two in advertising because we'll actually have a break-even business in year three. And so we're going to turn a loss in year two, but it's going to come back and help us in year three. So this is the type of situation you're always trying to figure out when you're working with businesses. So again, this shows why this type of analysis is so powerful. So finally, question three is, can you just spend your way to profitability at a flat customer acquisition cost? So meaning your marketing doesn't get any more efficient. It costs $75 to get a customer, period, no matter what. And let's say they're talking about year three. So spend your way to profitability in year three at a flat CAC. Okay, so we're going to be changing ad spend in year three, and CAC is not going to be changing. So how do we set this table up? Because, you know, one variable is not changing and the other is. Well, this one's pretty easy. So what we'll do is we'll just copy a part of the table. So here you'll have CAC, and you'll just put in your normal CAC number, delete out everything inside the table, and then ad spend. So they're saying, you know, can you just spend millions and millions of dollars and you'll be profitable? So let's see. Okay, so let's start at $500,000 in spending. I think I just put in $5 million. And let's just add $1 million a year to it. $1 million in each cell. So I think I need to expand the column a little. Okay, cool. Great. And so now this is ad spend in year three, and this is CAC in year three, and this is $75. So let's just label that so that we don't get confused. And here we link in operating profit, which is EBIT, earnings before interest and taxes, in year three. Link it in. Now highlight the entire table. Make a guess. Do you think this is going to get us profitable? So the row input here, customer acquisition cost in year three. Column input is advertising spend in year three. So what we see here is actually the more we spend, the bigger of a loss we turn, assuming that we're spending within the same year. So we saw in this table that if we spend a lot in advertising in year two, we actually end up profitable in year three. So in this situation, we're saying if we spend a lot of advertising in year three, well, we won't be profitable in year three. Probably would be closer to profitability in year four. But in this situation, we'd go back to our investors and say, we cannot spend our way to profitability, assuming we ramp it up in year three. That's just not possible mathematically. So I just showed you three sensitivity analysis break-even point tables. So I hope you feel really confident performing those and doing that analysis yourself. By the way, in the description below, you can download this Excel file completely for free. I've also linked to some of my other startup and finance focused videos as well. And if you found this content valuable, please subscribe and click the alerts notification, like this video, and leave me a comment below. And also check out my online courses if you need to improve your Excel and finance skills. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.